1935, August. I'd been back 3 months in the old country now, frankly wondering why. The weather made me liverish, no exercise to speak of, and talk of the ordinary Englishman made me sick. I'd had enough of restaurants and parties and race. As for Dad, he forbade his son from watching him race. A night would start with 20 cars speeding round the track, and by the end, there would be just one car still standing. Drivers often got badly injured in the pile-ups, and sometimes spectators did too, if the cars crashed into the stands. "It's dangerous, mate," said Dad. Gilbert always called his son mate. They were father and son, but best friends too. "Dad," the boy would plead, as his father tucked him up in bed. Chip Peddleston, engineering, chief technical officer, personal log, outgoing message, Sol 3, autumn, first year. "You hear that, Archie? It's your brother, calling from Mars. Just got back from our first trek to the surface, followed by 30 hours of quarantine. Damn robots, analyzing and groping. I'm sorry I'm not speaking. I'm sorry. I know it's weird, but I'm trying to work out how to handle this who to be, because I'm two different people with the two of you when you're separate, and now I'm in the middle." She wasn't pretty. She was spectacular. Eric scowled. Never in the history of GCHQ had they hired non-military for the field. "Is that a Dalmatian onesie?" he said. Control shrugged. Eric looked down at the candidates.
"As long as you kept your head down, you were comparatively safe." So as it went on, this is where I had my first escape. I was on sentry duty for a couple of hours, from 1 a.m. to 3 a.m. I was instructed to keep a sharp lookout. I didn't care for the idea of keeping my head above the trench and looking for beastly Germans. However, it had to be done.